Alright. So the way you handle all these, so if you're looking at the sine of 4 pi over 3, what you want to do is say, okay, the denominator is 3. Okay. So every time you have a 3, you have to remember what the sine is. It's the y coordinate, it's root 3 over 2. Alright, and then 4 pi over 3, you have to recognize where that is. So since the numerator is 1 more than the denominator, that tells you it's down there from what we just talked about. And down there, the y-coordinate's negative, so the sine's negative. So the answer would be negative root 3 over 2. Yes, sir?
So for 5, would that be 0, or would that be... 3
pi? So there's our 2 pi. There's our 3 pi. So yes, since the y-coordinate is 0, the sine is 0. Good? Okay. So basically anything in the 3 family is related to that. So it's a 30, 60, 90. The hypotenuse is 1. That means the short leg is 1 half. And the long leg is root 3 over 2. In each quadrant, anything with a 3, that's what it looks like. So when you go back to the unit circle, and so when you go back to the unit circle, there's our pi over 3, which has the root 3 over 2. So that means the 2 pi over 3, the 4 pi over 3, and the 5 pi over 3 all are going to have sine of root 3 over 2. So anything with a 3, the cosine is 1 half, the sine is root 3 over 2. And then basically you just have to realize whether it's positive or negative. Got me? So like here, everything's positive. Over here, the sine and cosecant would be positive, everything else would be negative. Down here, both sine and cosine are negative. So that would turn tangent into a positive. And over here, the sine's positive and the cosine is negative. So like if you come to like a problem like number 9, where it's secant negative 17 pi over 4, you have to keep adding it until it's positive. So if we double 4, we have 8. So we would keep adding 8 pi over 4 until it's positive. And eventually we'd be at 7 pi over 4. All right, so that's step 1. And then you have to remember secant is the inverse of cosine. All right, anything with a 4, the sine and cosine is root 2 over 2. Since secant's the inverse of that, that means the secant equals root 2 because that's the inverse of root 2 over 2. And then you have to remember 7 pi over 4. That's in this quadrant. In that quadrant, cosine's positive because the x positive, so you're done. So that's why your answer is root 2. So step 1 is to get it between 0 and 2 pi. Step 2 is remember what angle gives us that. And then step 3 is the proper sine, positive and negative. Anybody else from that section? Everybody's good? Number 4. The tangent of negative 3 pi over 2. Okay, the first thing we've got to do is turn it into a positive. So we double the numerator. What's double 2? 4. So we're going to add 4 pi over 2. Alright, that eventually gets us to pi over 2. Alright, which means we're right here at 0, 1. Okay, tangent is defined as y over x. The y is 1, the x is 0. Since we can't divide a number from 0 last week, that's an example of one that does not exist. Yep.